cancer.
It scares the hell out of me.
Cancer? It sucks. I hate cancer.
What I think about cancer?
You don't want to know.
Cancer changed my life and took my grandfather. My name is Stephanie Frugier. I am the current president of the Houston chapter of Young Texans Against Cancer.
Yeah, my name's Sam Bowen. I work for Bowen, McClellan, Britt. I'm an oil and gas insurance broker. Live in Houston, Texas. Been born and raised here. I like long walks on the beach.
My name is Houston Simmons. I'm an associate at Tudor Pickering Holt & Company, which is an energy investment and merchant bank. I've been looking for a way to make an impact in the community.
I'm Tom Brock, and I'm the marathon chair. My day job is teaching Spanish at St. Thomas High School.
Cancer affected my life when I experienced my grandfather battling cancer. They found a tumor in his heart, and just seeing that and what it did to not only him, but to our family was just horrific. I mean, it was game-changing. It was life-changing. We never had experienced that. And he taught me a long time ago that you need to give back, and you need to find a cause, and you need to find something to believe in and something to give your time, money, and effort to. I was impressed with Young Texans Against Cancer because it is run by 100% young professionals. It's our peer group, and we're making a difference and trying to create awareness early on and teach people about cancer now rather than in their 40s and 50s. That's how cancer affected my life, and that's why I chose YTAC.
My grandfather was a big golfer, and so he would pick me up in the afternoon, and we'd go out, hit golf balls, pick up golf balls. He showed up one day, and he had these they were kind of galls on his face. He'd obviously had to have some sort of skin cancer removed from his face. YTAC, extremely impressed. They weren't doing this to have their name on the list. They weren't doing this to say, I'm on the board of YTAC. They were doing this because it was something they were passionate about and enjoyed doing. And so that's something I really liked.
I think the two main ways that the organization has really affected me would be, one, it has provided an outlet for me as my family and friends have struggled with cancer. They can seek out organizations like YTAC to feel like they're doing something about it and they're fighting back on some level. And so it has been really relieving to me to have that outlet in YTAC. Second, it has shown me how much young people are capable of doing in a completely volunteer-run organization.
I joined YTAC for several reasons. I think I actually came across it randomly with a friend who was involved who was looking for some volunteers to come out and just participate in some of the events. And at the time, it was pretty relevant because it was several months after my dad passed away. The idea of trying to get involved with something that was cancer related at a young professional level sounded pretty appealing, and one thing led to another, and I've been development chair for the last year and a half.
I initially got involved in YTAC when I moved here in 2005 from San Antonio. I knew about maybe five people, and of course I wanted to get to know people and develop a group of friends, and so I joined just about every single young professional organization that exists here in Houston, Texas. But the one that ended up dedicating my volunteer time to is YTAC. My mom, she passed away in January 14th, 2000 from lung cancer. She'd been a lifelong smoker.
Really, that was the thing that made me want to dedicate myself to YTAC. It's been an amazing experience. It's actually been a life-changing experience for me. I never realized the impact that I was going to have on other people's lives. The way that what we do, allowing these people to become a part of our team YTAC, how we actually change their lives. And the first thing that comes to mind are the Sulak sisters. They're amazing people. One thing that they told me was that it was very much a therapeutic experience for them. With all the outpour and the response that they got for people who were helping them raise money for YTAC, I was blown away.
The Krista Stalen Foundation was very fortunate to be the recipient of the initial fundraising efforts from YTAC. What stands out and what distinguishes YTAC from other fundraising groups are three features. Number one, loyalty. Once they commit to you, they remain committed. And to a small organization like ourselves, this is so extremely important. Number two is genuine interest. I would suspect that no less than 60 or 70 YTAC members have toured our research facility. And then number three, I think, is focus. I have yet to meet a YTAC member that is not passionate about trying to make a difference in the cancer war.
MD Anderson has an extreme appreciation for Young Texans Against Cancer because we know that you all are enthusiastically spending time raising funds through marathons and golf tournaments and happy hours to fund local research. And since 2009, Young Texans Against Cancer has given MD Anderson over $400,000 for areas such as uterine cancer, ovarian cancer, esophageal, and now it'll be forthcoming melanoma as well. And we're just really pleased that we've been able to acknowledge these efforts through a plaque that's located in the lymphoma and myeloma clinic here at MD Anderson. And the impact is tremendous. I think a part of our mission is to create awareness through the community, and that's a mission, I believe, that's YTAC's as well. We know that more than 1.5 million Americans will be diagnosed with cancer in a year, but that we're making headway, and the progress in that factor is through generous contributions such as those that are like Young Texans Against Cancer making donations to the institution. And the fact that you all have chosen to actively be involved with us encourages others to do the same, which is very
reluctantly crouched at the starting line. Engines pumping and thumping in time. The green light flashes, the flags go up. Churning and burning, they yearn for the cup. They deftly maneuver and muscle for rank. Fuel burning fast on an empty tank. Reckless and wild, they pour through the turns. Their prowess is potent and secretly stern. As they speed through the finish, the flags go down. The fans get up and they get out of town. The arena is empty, except for one man still driving and striving as fast as he can. The sun has gone down and the moon has come up. And long ago somebody left with the cup. But he's driving and striving and hugging the turns and thinking of someone for whom he still burns. He's going the distance. He's going for speed. She's all alone in a time of need. Because he's racing and pacing and plotting the course. He's fighting and biting and riding on his horse. He's going the distance.
The fact that I know that YTAC is making a difference in these people's lives, it's a very gratifying experience.
Oh, we were walking in here to see.